In Databricks, tables are categorized as managed or external, each serving distinct purpose. In this video, I will show you how we can create, manage, and external table in Databricks. So let's get started. Let's understand what is managed and external tables. A managed table are fully controlled by Databricks. When you create a managed table, Databricks takes responsibility for both the metadata and the underlying data storage. This means that the table data is saved within a default location managed by the Databricks workspace, often in a dedicated storage account associated with your workspace. Databricks handles all aspects of table lifecycle. For example, if you delete a managed table, Databricks automatically deletes the corresponding data files. And this is a great option when you want an end-to-end solution without worrying about external dependencies or manual data management. Let's see. On the other side, the external tables. These are linked to data stored outside Databricks managed storage environment. When you create an external table, you must specify the exact location for the data, typically in a cloud storage like Azure Data Lake, Google Cloud Storage, or Amazon S3. This approach gives you more flexibility and control over the data since the data files are not physically resident in Databricks. Even if you drop the external table from Databricks, the online data files remain intact and accessible, making this a preferred choice when working with shared data sets or when integrating with other systems that also need access to the data. External tables are especially valuable when you want to maintain a single version of data that is used across different tools or platforms. Both managed and external tables can utilize Data Lake, which enhances their capabilities with features like ACID transactions, schema enforcement, and time travel. So let's see the practical side of how we can create managed and external tables in Databricks. All right, so I'm in the Microsoft Azure Databricks platform. Now, before we start building our managed and external tables, it is important we have a cluster which is up and running because we're going to attach the cluster to our notebook in order to perform our data processing. So to check for the cluster, I'm going to click on the compute on the left-hand side, and I've got this Databricks cluster which is up and running. Cool. Now, if you don't have this, just click on this create compute, provide all the details, and then click the create at the bottom. Now, since that is sorted, I'm going to come to this managed and external tables, and I've got this managed and external tables Databricks notebook. Now, we're going to build the manage table using the graphical user interface and then use the SQL to interact with the table. So before we do that, I'm going to quickly come to my Databricks one, and I've created this external table schema, which is going to house the external table. And then I've also created this manage table schema, which is going to house the manage table. And the manage, as we've said, is going to be managed entirely in the Databricks environment. Now let's see how we can create the manage table using the graphical user interface. Now I'm going to quickly come here, and then I want to come to the catalog, and I'm going to expand this Databricks catalog, and I want to select the manage table schema. So click on that. For now, we do not have any data, so I'm going to click on create a table, and then I can browse my local file and bring some data. So I want to select this, say 2015 to 2018, and click open at the bottom. And then we can see this is going to automatically select the Databricks one catalog. And then we have this manage table schema selected. And then we have this the first file in the selected files. So I'm going to call this one sales table. And I can see the preview of the data. We can see all the columns. We can also interact as much as we like. And then I'm going to click on create table at the bottom. So in a matter of seconds, we have our managed table created. Cool. So we can see sales table. In the overview, we can see the owner, data source, popularity, last updated, and the size, which is just 8.2 kilobytes with just 4 files. Now I'm going to click on the sample data tab. I can see the sample data for preview. Now when I click on the details tab, I can see that this is a managed table type, and then we have the storage location, the properties, and so on and so forth. Now I'm going to come here, and I'm going to refresh, and then I can see the by clicking on this, I can go to the manage table, and then we have this sales table. Now I'm going to right click on it, and there's an option to preview in new cell. Click on that, and then a cell is created at the bottom for us immediately. So we can see using the SQL magic command use catalog named Databricks 1, and this is selecting all the rows from the man table dot sales table table name, and then we have this one on the records, which is absolutely cool. Now I'm going to create a cell at the bottom, and then I'm going to quickly go up and I'm going to copy this. So I'm going to copy that, and I can come to the bottom and I can run the describe extended on that. So I'm going to use the magic command SQL and use the describe extended, and then I'm going to love to provide the name of the catalog. So Databricks one, and then I'm going to do dot and paste this. So we have the fully qualified name. I'm going to press Control Enter, and then we can see the tilde is really important in order for this to work. And then we can come here, we can see all the information like the column name, the data type, we have the delta statistics. Now when I scroll to the bottom, we can see the main path, which is the type as a managed table, which is cool. So that's basically how we can create a managed table. And as I've explained, once I issue a drop command, which I'm going to do later on, everything is going to be deleted without anything retained. Now, having seen this, we want to see how we can create our external table, which is a little bit more time consuming. First, I'm going to come to the portal.azure.com. So I'm going to create Access Connector, which is going to provide us a secure managed identity to enable Databricks seamlessly access and authenticate our Azure data lake. So to do that, I'm going to look for the Access Connector for Azure Databricks. If you couldn't see it here, just come here and search for Access Connector and just click on it. So I'm going to create a new one, click on the create, and I'm going to choose the resource group to house that connector. And I'm going to just call this one demo connector. You can use whatever name you like. And I'm going to choose the region, which is the closest to me, that is UK South, and then click on the review plus create. We can see the details, click on create. And in a matter of seconds, we have this deployed, and then we can move to the next stage. Okay, so we can see go to resource. So we can see this is now created. Now we're going to grant the newly created Access Connector storage blob data contributor on the storage account. So I'm going to quickly come to this tab, and I want to grant that on top of this Cornerstone Analytics storage account. So click on that. And then I want to go to the access control, the IAM, and I want to add a new role assignment, and I want to search for storage blob data contributor. So we can see that here, which allows write delete access to Azure storage blob containers and data. So select this and click on next, and then I'm going to choose the manage identity as the service principal, and I want to select the members. So I'm going to see the subscription, and I want to choose the manage identity, which is going to be in this case Access Connector for Azure Databricks. And then I can select the demo connector we just created at the bottom. We can click on this, and we can see the preview here. Cool. Click on review plus create, and then click on that again. Okay, so this is now sorted. Now to verify, I can come to the role assignments, and then I can see demo connector, which is now registered in there. Now I'm going to create credentials in Databricks, and that represents authentication and authorization mechanism to access our ADLS. So I'm going to come here, and then I can go back to the catalog, and I'm going to click on this get settings, and I'm going to click on credentials. So in the credentials, I'm going to create a new credential. So click on that, and it's going to be storage credential. And of course, this is going to be Azure Managed Identity credential type. So I'm going to call this on my ADLS credential. And then we're going to provide the Access Connector ID that is part of what we created in Access Connector. So I can come here, and I can go back home, and I can come here, look for the demo connector we just created, and then we need the resource ID. So just copy this to the clipboard. I can come back here and paste in this Access Connector ID. And then for the user assigned managed identity, this is optional, click on create at the bottom. So we can see successful, your storage credential, blah, 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 is now created. So we can see the details. We can see this is a managed identity and the purpose is storage and so on and so forth. That's cool. Now, we want to go ahead and create an external location to access our data stored in the ADLS. So I can come out to the Catalog Explorer. I can click on this guest settings. I can go to the external locations. And then I'm going to click on create external location. And I'm going to give this a nice name. I'm going to call this on my external location. You can use whatever name you like. It's absolutely fine. And then we're going to provide the bucket path that you want to use as the external location. So I'm going to quickly come back to the Cornerstone Analytics storage account. And I'm going to search for endpoint at the bottom. Click on that. And then I'm going to quickly scroll down and look for the primary endpoint data lake storage. So this contains the dfs.core.windows.net, and I'm just going to make some modifications to that and then use it. So come back here or here, and I'm going to just use this comment box for now. And first, the convention is to use the ABFSS protocol. So I'm going to get rid of this hypertext transfer protocol and use the ABFSS. And then we have the :// and then we're going to provide the container name. Now the container is going to be, but let me just come here and show you. I'm going to come to my containers. I've created a dedicated sales data container. So I can come back here and use the sales data and use the at symbol because it must follow this convention, container, and then at study account name, which is this, and then we have the rest. So I can copy or cut this and paste in it. And that's all we need to do. So we're going to provide the storage credential we just created not too long. And click on this. We can see the My ADLS credential, which is Manage Identity. And then we can see the connector ID. We can see that this is User Assigned Managed Identity ID. So I can scroll down and click on Create at the bottom. So we can see your external location is now created. And then we can see the overview. We can come to the permissions. We can come to the browse. And if we have any data in that sales data container, we're going to see it automatically. So that is sorted. Now we want to go ahead and create our managed table. So let me quickly scroll up. There is a code I prepared. Now we're going to be using this sample sales transaction table that is part of the many sample data in Databricks. So I'm going to press Control Enter to run this code, so that we can see the content of the table. So basically we have this transaction ID, customer ID, franchise, date time, product column, and then we have the quantity, unit price, total price, and so on and so forth. And this is absolutely cool for any play around. So that's created. Now we're going to create the managed or the external table on top of this data. So I'm going to scroll down at the bottom, and before we create that, we're going to instruct Databricks to use the sales. We're going to actually use this Databricks, not sales. So I'm going to quickly get rid of this and type in Databricks one, and then we're going to use the external table that we created, which is this one here. You can see for now we do not have any data. So use Databricks one catalog and then use the external table schema. So press Control Enter and this is now executed. Proceed to create table if not exist, and this table is named sales transactions as external table. And then we're going to be using the Delta format, and then we specify the location, so which is my sales data container. So we also use the add select, so we're selecting all the rows from the samples.bighouse.sales transaction table. So I'm going to press Control Enter to run this, and there we go. So this executed. So when I expand this SQL DF, we have the number affected rows and the number inserted rows. So that is cool. Now I'm going to click on this refresh catalog, and I can expand this Databricks one. I can expand the external table, and there we go. So we can say sales transaction is not created. So when I come to this tab, I can go to the catalog, I can go refresh, click on this to expand. I can see the external table, and then we have the table. Now when I go to the details, we can see this is an external table type, which is absolutely straightforward and easy. Now I'm going to come here and then I can scroll to the bottom. So we're just going to run this describe extended command on the same sales transaction as external table, just to see the same details. So press Ctrl Enter to run this using the magic command. Again, we can see the column named data type, and then when I scroll to the bottom, we can see this is an external table type in Databricks. Absolutely cool. Now we're going to go ahead and drop the sales transaction data. When I press Ctrl Enter, see what happened. This is okayed. And when I click on this refresh catalog and expand this Databricks one, we can come to the external table. We can see this has deleted the table. But when I go to the sales data and I refresh this, and there we go. So we can see we have all the metadata and all the delta log files. So when I click on this, we have the JSON transaction log, which contains record of all transactions, both insert, update, and delete performed on our table, with each transaction containing a sequential number. And then we have this 0000.crc, which is the delta index file, which helps us to track changes and improve query efficiency. So we can also see that this is committed. So this simply means that the transaction was fully committed. So as soon as we deleted the table from here, we can see the table is gone. But because this is an external table, all the files are still retained in the Azure container here. Now let's go back and finish this off. I'm going to quickly go to the bottom, and then we can drop the manage table. So I'm going to copy all of these, and I can create a cell at the bottom or at the top. I can use the drop table, and of course the magic command is automatically applied because this is in SQL. So I'm going to just paste these and press Ctrl Enter. So you can see this has dropped the table. So when I refresh and I go to the Databricks and I click on the manage table, we can see everything is deleted, both the underlying files and the delta log. So this is how we can create and manage external and manage table in Databricks. I trust you enjoyed this video. If you do, like, comment, share, and follow me for more videos. Thank you for watching. Bye for now.